Hello student, how are you? I think all of you are fine. So can you remember the subject engineering mechanics? In the last class that we have discussed the moment of a force. So based on that, today we are going to discuss the shear force and bending moment. First we need to know what is shear force. The force that causes shear. Then what is shearing? Shear means a cutting. Simply, a shear means, let's consider a scissor. You want to cut it, cut the piece by two pieces. Then what is happening? This cutting is called shearing. And with the help of these two arms, we are applying the shear force. So shear force is here to equal and opposite force. Always not necessary that you have to apply both the forces. Rather, you are using a knife and want to cut it. So one force is given by the knife, other force is the resistance. Say it is supported by your hand or by the table, then table is giving a support, means equivalent opposite force that you are using with the help of this knife. So always these two equivalent opposite forces are there, and the line of action of these two forces is not exactly same, but a small misalignment is there. Then a cutting operation is going on. This type of cutting is called shearing. So that we are going to discuss today the shearing, shear force, the force that causes the shear, the magnitude of the force. And we have learnt about the different types of beam in the last lecture 2. And this is the lecture number 3. In this lecture, we will discuss this shear force on that beam and the bending moment. We also have discussed in the last lecture what is the moment of a force. You know, moment of force means this is the moment which causes the angular acceleration of the body. Now, if the body is not free to rotate, some constants are there, then under the action of the bending, action of the moment of force, the body will tend to bend. Then that moment is called the bending moment. Let's consider a simply supported beam under the action of a force. As it is supported by two supports, so if you are applying a force, it is unable to rotate. In that case, a bending causes. The reason of this bending is the bending moment, or bending is caused by the bending moment. So this is all, this is the shear force and bending moment, and in details we will discuss that. And we also have to find out here the relationship between the load intensity, shear force and bending moment. Now let's go to the topic.
So shear or shearing means a cutting, and the force that is applied to cut is the shear force. Let's consider it's a beam or bar. Two forces applied there, and definitely there is a misalignment between the line of action of the force. Then only a shearing will happen. Though this misalignment magnitude is very small, almost the line of action of both these forces is same. Now, what force is responsible for this shearing or cutting? As a result of this shearing, the two parts of the beam is divided and the responsible force is the shear force, which is denoted by Fs. Here also, not necessarily that you are applying both this opposite force Fs and Fs. Rather, you are applying one force and another force is the resistance of the material. Due to this two force, a shearing is happening. And as resistance is always equal and opposite to the direction of the force. Now let's consider another example. It's a riveted joint, two plate, metallic plate, let's consider two metallic plate is joined by a rivet. This is the rivet. In the old days structures, this riveted joint is frequently observed, like in our well-known Howrah bridge. All joints of Howrah bridge is by riveted joint. Though nowadays the application of this riveted joint is no more. Whatever. So the plate 1 and 2 is joined by this riveted joint. Now if you apply a P force here and here, equal and opposite in direction, then a shear force will work to the rivet as shown in figure. And as a result, there may be a breaking or cutting of the rivet from this section. This is the shear deformation, or the shear deformation is the cutting of the rivet. Now, not necessary that you are applying P and P. If one end is fixed with a structure and you are applying at one end P, then as a reaction of this Fs is caused due to this P. Now, due to this Fs, a reaction will be given by the support to this plate 2. This is the another P or applied force P, and that gives rise to the shear force Fs, which is acting on the rivet. So let's see the steps again. You are applying a force P to the plate. The plate is giving a force to the rivet, which is the shear force. Again, directly you are applying another force P, or by a support you are applying the force to the plate 2, and this gives rise the shear force here. Now we'll learn how to find out the shear force and bending moment at any particular section of a beam, which is subjected to a number of forces F1, F2 and F3. At first, we will draw a free body diagram of the beam. You know that due to the presence of this pent support, as per the discussion of our lecture 1, for the pin support, there is two component of reaction, R1X and R1Y. Whereas in case of roller support, only vertical component of reaction, that is R2. Now, resolve the forces in x and y direction. R1, F1, all these are horizontal or vertical. So, you only need to resolve the F2 force in x and y direction, that is F2x and F2y are the components of this force. Now, let's consider an arbitrary shear force Fs. It is the magnitude we are assuming and the direction. Not necessarily, again, the direction is upward only, it may be downward depending on the magnitude, whatever we are going to drive. And consider a bending moment here. The direction of bending moment also are arbitrary. Before discussing, we need to know what is this bending moment. We know moment of a force that causes the angular acceleration of the body. But if the angular acceleration is restricted, as per example, this due to the presence of the support, the beam restricted for its free rotation. In that case, the moment of these forces, F1, F2, and F3, and reaction forces, moment of all these forces causes the bending deformation of the beam. Then, this particular moment of force is called as bending moment. We need to know how to calculate the bending moment. The bending moment is present everywhere on the beam, as well as the shear force. Though the force is applied at a particular points, like here, here, and here, but bending moment and shear force both is present everywhere as an effect of these forces. We have to find out that shear force and bending moment. Now let's consider a section A. At this particular section, what is the bending moment and shear force? For that, we have assumed Fs and M. We have to find out the value of Fs and M. First, go through the static equilibrium condition. We know that it is in a static equilibrium. So, summation of Fy is 0. We are not interested about Fx, as the shear force is only due to the vertical forces. So, summation of Fy 0, then F2y, this force downward considered is positive, F1 is also positive downward, R1y, this is upward, so negative, and Fs is negative. So, finally, from this equation, Fs is equals to F2y plus F1 minus R1y. If this value is positive, the calculated value is positive, then the direction of Fs is right. Otherwise, you have to reverse the direction. If negative, then you have to reverse the direction. Now, for the right part of the section, this section, again, you can calculate. And here also, Fs equals to R2 minus F3. That we are calculating from summation of Fy, because this part is also in static equilibrium. Applying the same condition, summation of Fy equals to 0. And we can prove that both this value, Fs, this Fs and this Fs, is equal and opposite in direction. Now, to find out the moment working here, this capital M. You know, total moment of the beam summation is 0, as it is in static equilibrium. It is not rotating. So, moment is 0. Then what is summation of this moment? Moment of all the forces. And the resistive moment, this moment. We have to find out the magnitude of this moment. Now, due to as it is the static equilibrium, so moment of all these forces is zero. And these are the corresponding distance. You know, distance is required to find out the moment. Now, say F1, L1. This is the moment caused due to F1. Already we have discussed that moment of a force equals to force into perpendicular distance. So, from the perpendicular distance from axis of rotation, we are trying to calculate the moment of force about A point. Means, about A point, you have to calculate it. Or, you are assuming the beam can rotate only about point A under the action of F1 force. And to find out the effect of F1, you will consider no other forces, these forces are present. Okay, fine. Now, under the action of this F1, what is the moment? F1 into perpendicular distance from A, say F1 into L1. What is the direction? Under the action of this force, the beam tends to rotate anti-clockwise direction. For the moment, two directions is there, clockwise and anti-clockwise. Let us consider anti-clockwise is positive. So F1 L1 is positive. Then clockwise direction rotation moment is negative. Now R1Y. This force distance is L1R. So the magnitude of this moment is R1Y into L1R. But what is the direction? Under the action of this force, the beam tends to rotate in clockwise direction with respect to A. With respect to A means, if A point is pinned and you are applying a force R1Y, then the beam will rotate in clockwise direction around A. So, as it is clockwise, so we are considering it is the negative. As anti-clockwise is considered positive, so clockwise is negative, or vice versa. So it is negative. Then F2Y. What's the distance of this force? L2. So L2 into F2Y. This is also anti-clockwise, so it is positive. So it is positive. Now, this is the moment. It is clockwise. So again, negative. So this is the equation. The summation of all these moment equals to zero. This moment is the resistive moment. The material gives the resistance to make it static. Now, from this equation, we are deriving M equals to this. It indicates that this resistive moment or this bending moment equals to summation of all the moment of the forces, all forces acting on the body. And the shear force equals to summation of all the forces acting on the body. Now, at this condition of equilibrium, we are getting the effect of shear force, the resultant shear force working at any particular instant. With another example, we'll try to find out the relation between shear force and the bending moment. There is a relationship between the load intensity, this omega, shear force,
unbending moment. Now, we are trying to find out the relationship between these three quantities. Let's consider a beam is subjected to a uniformly distributed load omega newton per meter. It is simply supported beam at two ends. The reactions are R1 and R2. Now, there is no horizontal component of applied forces, and that's why though it is the pin support, but no horizontal reaction is also there. Because you know, reaction is only there if any action is there, action force or applied force is there. In horizontal direction, there is no applied force, no reaction component. So in both the support, pin and roller, only the vertical component of reaction is present. Now, try to find out the magnitude of this reaction force. We know the equivalent load for this uniformly distributed load is omega into L. That already we have discussed. And it is working at the center. Now, being static, we can apply the condition of static equilibrium, summation of Fy0. So, R1 plus R2, because both is upward, and omega L, it is downward, so it is minus, equals to 0. The reactions R1 and R2 here is symmetric, it is a symmetric body. That's why substituting the R1 equals to R2 in this equation, we are getting R1 equals to R2 equals to omega L by 2. Now, let us consider any particular section C and draw the free body diagram of this section AC. This is the diagram. Now, for this section, it is from C, it is detached from rest of the part of the beam, and the effect of this rest of the part is replaced by a shear force Fs and a bending moment M. Now, the equivalent diagram is this, where the uniformly distributed load is converted to concentrated load omega x, because here length is x. And it is acting to the middle of this section, means at a distance of x by 2. Now, apply the condition of static equilibrium, it is also static. Considering the condition of static equilibrium, summation of Fy equals to 0. So, Fs equals to Fs plus R1 minus omega s equals to 0. As Fs and R1 both is upward and omega x is downward, so it is negative. One should be noted here that here we have assumed Fs is upward, but not necessarily that you have to consider upward only, because we don't know the magnitude and direction of Fs. We have to find out Fs. So, we can consider any magnitude Fs and any direction upward or downward. If Fs, the calculated value of Fs from this equation is positive, then this direction is right. Otherwise, if it is negative, then you have to reverse the direction here. Finally, from this equation, we are getting that the shear force Fs is a function of x. So, differentiating Fs with respect to x, we are getting omega. It indicates that rate of change of shear force with respect to the distance equals to load intensity omega. Again, consider the moment, the resistive moment here, M. Now, summation of MC equals to 0. Summation of MC means you will consider moment of all the forces about C. Means, under the action of any force, the beam can rotate about C point only. Now consider this effect of this M resistive moment. Like shear force, it is also arbitrary. Here it is selected anti-clockwise. So let's consider the anti-clockwise moment is positive. So M. Now R1 is upward, and if there is no other forces under the action of R1, the beam, the AC part will rotate in clockwise direction about C, around C. So this moment R1 into X, this direction of this is clockwise, whereas we have assumed anti-clockwise negative. So R1X is negative, as anti-clockwise is positive. So R1X, it is negative, being clockwise direction. Now this omega X, it is working through the middle. First, the distance of this force is from the end C, it is X by 2. So the moment equals to this omega X into X by 2. What's the direction? Under the action of these forces, it can rotate in clockwise direction about C. So again, this being clockwise, so it is also positive. So it is plus. Now find out the value of M, which is equals to omega L by 2. Omega L by 2 into X. R value of R1 is omega L by 2 into X minus omega X into X by 2. Or M equals to omega LX by 2 minus omega X square by 2. It's a function. Again, it's a function of X. Now differentiate this value of M with respect to X. So we are getting dm by dx equals to omega L by 2 minus omega X. So what is this? This is equals to the shear force here. So the magnitude is opposite. Direction is also opposite, negative. Otherwise, magnitude is same. Thus, the shear force at any point equals to dm by dx. Means differentiating the moment, we are getting the shear force. Now, the rate of change of moment with respect to distance is the shear force. Again, rate of change of the shear force with respect to the distance equals to the load index. All this condition is summarized here. The area of this shear force diagram to the left or the right of the section is equal to the moment at that section. As we have discussed that in case of the distributed moment, the force equals to the force into distance. See, if we draw force versus distance diagram, the moment is the area. So similarly, all these are the condition of properties of shear force and bending moment diagram. Now, some sign conventions are there. So when it will be said that it is positive bending and when it is negative bending. Under the action of bending moment, if the beam bends like this, concave shape, then the corresponding bending moment is considered positive bending, whereas in the convex shape, it is called the negative bending. Similarly, for a beam, due to the presence of shear force, if the left part of the beam move up and right part is moved down, then the shear force is considered positive shear. Whereas if the left part is moving down and right part is moving up, it is considered the negative shear. Though it is not absolutely always we have to consider this direction only. We have a free hand to choose a direction of any bending moment. But only things is that whatever direction we are selecting, if that is positive, the reverse direction will be negative. Okay, this is all about our shear force and bending moment conceptions. Now, the references that I have used to prepare these videos, video lectures are these.
Malo.
Okay, student, so this is about the shear force and bending moment, and we also have found out the relation between shear force and bending moment with load intensity. I think you have understood. If you have any query, you are make free to contact. And in the next lecture, we are going to discuss the shear force and bending moment diagram in lecture 4. You are requesting to follow that lecture. Thank you. Thank you for listening and your patience on the present lecture. Thank you.